Alright, ladies and gentlemen, before we get started, and before we run down the card, I found out that a member of the agency that I'm in passed away. Her name was Queen Shade. We do not know what happened to her. So tonight's show is dedicated to her. Tonight's show is also dedicated to GCW superfan and deathmatch fan Piss Jug Mike, who passed away today after complications with cancer. And I want to kind of break the fourth wall here for a moment. So as some of you may know that have talked to me personally or have followed me for a long period of time on various amounts of social media, I had a cyber stalker. And my cyber stalker harassed me for 3 years, just relentlessly. Put me through so much mental hell. And just caused me to have a lot of trauma within trying to open up to people and shit like that. Well, the other day she passed away at the age of 24. She has a history of seizures and stuff like that from a traumatic brain injury that happened when she was young. I'm going to read you a statement in a matter of moments here. I'm just waiting for my Instagram to update. Quite convenient with the time, don't you think? So, I'm going to read you the statement I put out. And this is what I wrote. My cyber stalker died. I don't know how to feel, to be honest. Part of me feels for her family. But part of me is relieved that I don't have to endure the stalking anymore. Siddles, I will say this. I hope you're not suffering anymore, and I hope you are at peace. And to your family, I send my condolences to them. Though you stalked me relentlessly for 3 years, and I want to say I forgive you for those 3 years of cyber paranoia you put me through. I forgive you for causing me to be so afraid to get close to people. I forgive you for everything you've done to me and my friends and family. Though the anxiety will fade over time, I forgive you for the mental hell I was put under. All in all, I write this to finally have closure. Rest easy, Siddles. So, that was the statement I wrote about what happened with my cyber stalker. So, my condolences go out to Sydney's family. My condolences go out to Queen Shade's family. My condolences go to Piss Jug Mike's family. But yeah. Now, away from the sad, let's get into the insane. So, we're going to talk a bit about what happened on my friend's show. Okay, PVW Quest for Glory. Let's run down the results before we run down our card. Our opening contest for PVW Quest for Glory were for the tag team titles. You had King Boss and Saren Cross taking on Doohop and Chris Miller. And as I predicted, King Boss and Saren Cross would win. And our second match was for the Women's Championship. We had Ketty James taking on Casey Spinelli. Ketty James would pick up the win. Then we had the PVW Intercontinental Championship on the line as Derek the Punisher Reed took on Big Daddy Stretch, Darren Ship. Your winner and new Intercontinental Champion was Derek the Punisher Reed. Then we had the Women's Quest for Glory match. Your winner of that going to the WrestleMania of PVW. We have Maddie Red going on to whichever, I can't remember what it is. And then the Men's Quest for Glory match, the number 30 entrant, Psycho Man, won. Then the All-National World Heavyweight Championship match, Chris Miller versus Elite Geek. Once again, Elite Geek proves his dominance and defeats Chris Miller. So, that's PVW Quest for Glory. Golden Mania. I got it. Maddie Red and Psycho Man will be going to Golden Mania. Now, let's run down what we have for you this week. Because next show, the go-home show, will be this upcoming Monday. And then on the 29th, we are actually going to be live. Get this, ladies and gentlemen. Rite of Spring will be at Memorial Gardens in North Bay, Ontario, and we already have 5 matches confirmed. But you're going to have to tune in at the Go Home show to figure out which matches we're talking about. So this is episode 7 from a very exciting location. Matt Tremont is happy to have us here at the H2O Wrestling Center, the Kevin Hogan Memorial Arena. And this is what's going to be taking place. We have the new GCW Women's or GCW Champion, Masha Slamovich, taking on Dark Sheik and Edith Surreal in triple threat action. Then we have Jordan Devlin and Garrett Marks teaming up to take on No Chill Scotty Rivers and now deemed the Madhouse Marauder Mark Doering. Then we have Roderick Strong taking on Mick Adams for the Excalibur Championship. This will be Mick's 8th title defense. And we have the East-West Express, Nick Wayne and Jordan Oliver, taking on Breezango. We have a fatal 4-way match. Deonna Purrazzo, Abby Vex, Aaron Chaos, and Billy Starks will be tagging it up in the ring. Our co-main event will be under MMA rules. It's going to be Abyss versus Brock Lesnar. Then our main event in an Iron Man match, it's going to be MJF versus Kyle O'Reilly. So let's not waste any time. Live from the H2O Wrestling Center, tonight we bring you S.I.W. Agony brought to you in part by Patreon.com, Break the Bank Agency, Pro Virtual Wrestling, Undisputed Wrestling Oath, and GCWmerch.com. Fight Plus, IWTV, and Game Changer Wrestling. Tonight's show is in memory of Queen Shade from Big O Live and Break the Bank Agency. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to SIW Agony. I want to thank Matt Tremont for allowing us to participate here at the H2O Wrestling Center in Township, New Jersey. This is an absolute honor to have the Bulldozer accommodate us for this event. You've heard what's going to happen on the card. You've seen the matches that are up on deck. Let's not waste any time. Masha Slamovich, the newly crowned GCW champion, takes on Dark Sheik and Edith Surreal. What a way to kick things off tonight. You do not want to miss everything going forward. So let's not waste any time. I'm just gonna let everything play out. I'm gonna pull a Lionheart Hero here and just let this match play out. But I want to talk a bit about PVW before this match gets off the hook. If you guys haven't checked out Pro Virtual Wrestling, you need to. Just type in PVW Quest for Glory on your search bar on YouTube and go check out what just happened a couple days ago. Then hit that subscribe button on my friend Scotty Lionheart's channel. Do it. John Reggins is out with an injury because of Jesse Enigma, and he's got a lot to say when he comes back. Chris Miller, constantly being the target of every assault, both verbally and physically. You gotta wonder what that does to a man's psyche, so tune into that. Pro Virtual Wrestling, PVW, it's where it's at. Let's go. But this triple threat match, we're about to send it to the ring. The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a triple threat match featuring the ladies of SIW Wrestling. Introducing first, this is Dark Sheik. And here comes Dark Sheik making her way to the ring. Great response here from the H2O Center Wrestling Center fan base as Dark Sheik makes her way to the ring here. Very great athlete, very sweet person. Absolutely love this woman. And then again, I love all three women in this match. And here comes her opponent. And her opponents first. Ladies and gentlemen, she is Russian Dynamite. And your new GCW World Champion, Masha Slamovich. And here comes Masha Slamovich, Russian Dynamite. She looks ready for war. She looks ready to kill here at the H2O Wrestling Center. Masha Slamovich. ain't no joke. And neither is this final participant. And the final participant in this matchup. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Edith Surreal. And here she comes, a fan favorite, Edith Surreal. Don't let those pretty eyes fool you. She is as dangerous as she is desirable. So do not let those gorgeous eyes make you believe she is otherwise. So we got ourselves a nice little triple threat match to start things off. Here we go, triple threat action. As Dark Sheik and Edith Surreal now go into a lockup, clothesline into the corner. Both, look at this. Surreal trying to take control of the situation here. Dark Sheik getting lit up as Masha Slamovich was laid out in the corner momentarily. We got a sit out powerbomb as Russian Dynamite. Masha Slamovich is taking this match very nonchalant-like. Nice snap suplex, and now Dark Sheik gonna go in with a nice Hurricane Rana. Sheik now going in with these kicks and chops, and Masha thrown into the corner once again as Edith Surreal with a back body drop. Right there, nice backdrop suplex, I should say, as Edith Surreal taking control of this match. And, well, Dark Sheik got dumped to the outside here at the H2O Wrestling Center. And all hell is breaking loose in this match. As Edith Surreal is working the arm of Masha. Cover! No, just a one count. Now Dark Sheik is back in action here, back in the ring. Gonna dump Edith Surreal to the apron. And go right in for a, oh! Lays out Masha Slamovich with that shortstop Hurricane Rana. Everyone is just going absolutely insane in this matchup. Nice Rana there by Dark Sheik. Now Edith Surreal has control. Into the corner goes Dark Sheik. Dark Sheik now takes a forearm. A series of ruthless kicks and stomps to the chest of Dark Sheik. Now Masha Slamovich sending Edith Surreal to the outside as Dark Sheik rolled to the out herself. Russian Dynamite now in full momentum here. We got a knee bar on the outside here. The fans at the H2O Wrestling Center are cheering on Russian Dynamite, who defeated both Speedball Mike Bailey and Nick Gage recently. Masha Slamovich won the GCW Championship from Nick Gage, which was an insane thought in the process here, as Slamovich is dazed on the guardrails that Matt Tremont had to have us put up because of the regulations that are of SIW's nature. These guardrails are put in place to keep everybody safe. Oh, Dark Sheik is rolling in and out of the ring here as Edith Surreal got slammed into the steps. Dark Sheik's chopping the hell out of Masha Slamovich here, and a kick right to the back. Now a shot to the back by Eva Surreal as Dark Sheik is stuck onto the guardrail here momentarily. And what's this? Oh, getting dropped head first onto the barricade. Edith Surreal now has the momentum. Masha Slamovich now in the ring, taking the distraction to her advantage and drops her on her head. Masha just dropped Edith Surreal on her head as Dark Sheik finally comes to. We got ourselves a cover. One, two, broken up by Dark Sheik. Dark Sheik with a lockup now. That kick did not go anywhere as Masha Slamovich. Huge fall away slam. Edith Surreal is back on her feet. Masha Slamovich in control of Dark Sheik. What could she be thinking here? Oh, we got ourselves a double team here. Double DDT to Dark Sheik as she rolls out of the ring, and Edith Surreal with a flurried offense that gets momentarily blocked. Oh, no, 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 no. Package pile driver by Masha Slamovich. Masha now dragging Edith Surreal to the center of the ring. Cover. One, two, three. Masha Slamovich keeps her momentum going. Your winner of the match, Russian Dynamite, Masha Slamovich. Masha Slamovich keeps the momentum on her side. Successful nights in New York, Toronto, Ontario, and now at the H2O Wrestling Center. Well, folks, you want to talk success? We got success coming your way. We have the Sinful Youth versus Garrett Marks, as he teams with Jordan Devlin. So let's not waste any time in this next match. Sinful Youth, No Chill Scotty Rivers, and the Madhouse Marauder Mark Doering. They've been on a roll since their debut, which ironically, somebody thought was a personal attack against them, but hey. We all can't be, you know, level-headed half the time, so we have to at least have some sort of complex that keeps us, you know, unique. But I digress, all jokes aside. This tag team match won't be no joking matter. As I heard, Garrick Marks' teammates might be coming in, like his stablemates, eventually. So we have to see if Donovan Blake and Gary Hayes are going to make their debut here soon. But speaking of making debuts, there's some big news coming for next week, with Peyton Sawyer making her debut. That's going to be very exciting. That will be this Monday. But here we go. Sinful Youth versus the team of Jordan Devlin and Garrett Marks about to get underway. This match is brought to you in part by GCWmerch.com for all your GCW apparel. The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, SoCal's baddest, the Madhouse Marauder, Mark Doering, and No Chill Scotty Rivers. Together they are the Sinful Youth. Doering and Rivers exploding onto the scene as one of the hottest tag teams in SIW, and they got a very interesting match tonight. Tonight's show is also in memory of Queen Shade from my agency that I'm a part of. My condolences are to your family. Rest easy. And their opponents, introducing first, Jordan Devlin. And here comes Jordan Devlin. Jordan Devlin. JD McDonough. The Irish Ace. People call him the polished version of Finn Balor. That's exactly what I've heard many times. But Jordan Devlin, or JD McDonough, is one hell of an athlete. His tag team partner from the west side of the tracks, Garrett Marks. He is one third of the Sixth Street Mafia, a group of greasers known for being roughnecks and liking to hurt people. This is probably his second match here in SIW. Garrett's been really busy with his automotive shop as of late. He restores 1950s vintage vehicles. So, excuse his absence. So here we go. No Chill's gonna start things off as he gets chopped by Devlin. Devlin now in full. Oh! Don't discredit the strength of Scotty Rivers. Fun fact, Scott is his middle name. It's actually Sergio Rivers. Surge Scott Rivers, when he debuted on the YouNow era of CXW. As Rivers literally showing no chill, like his name is intended. Look at the strength of this young kid. Only 23 years old. Oh, look at this. He tags in Garrett Marks. Marks now taking the strikes by Rivers. Oh, look at this. Garrett Marks now in trouble early on in this matchup here as No Chill is taking it to him. Oh, look at this. Oh! Calculating the attack. Gonna try and sneak a victory here. These guys have been on a roll. Sinful Youth, no. Now what's this? Oh, look at this. Here comes the Madhouse Marauder himself. Oh, and he gets his jaw jacked. But that martial arts background comes into play with that nice turnover as he shifts the momentum back into the hands of Sinful Youth. The strike Garrett is feeling the abuse at this moment. Garrett marks. Oh! Gets power slammed, and we got a cover. One, two, nope. Garrett Marks is still in this match. As he comes back with some serious striking. Oh, that knee lift. He's known for that knee lift. He's also known for taking his knee lift in the You Now era and not coming back until recent. As Jordan Devlin is now taking the driver's seat and tossing the big man out. Referee Darian Wild in the ring here at the H2O Wrestling Center as Garrett Marks looks on at the calamity that is unfolding between Jordan Devlin and Mark Doring, who both missed their mark on their dives here at the H2O Wrestling Center. As Doring's now taking it to Devlin. And look at that. Sinful youth. Constantly with the momentum. And he's just was turning his back. And now we got ourselves a standoff. Oh, nice reversal. And we got some back and forth here. Jordan Devlin now trying to amount to a comeback here. Jawbreaker sending Mark Doring down. That tag back in goes to Garrett Marks, former two-time light heavyweight champion, two-time welterweight champion here in SIW, formerly known as CXW. And what's he got going for himself here? Oh, look at this. A beast of man coming in with that jackknife, and he goes for the cover. One, two, no. And it looks to me like we got ourselves a nice strike. Setting it up here, Garrett Marks in trouble. He calls that the Marauder Drive. One, two, and it's not over. Jordan Devlin taking an ass kicking, being thrown to the outside. That should take the cake for a series of strikes and clotheslines to Garrett Marks. A series of, no, reversal. Oh, Garrett Marks outsmarting Scotty Rivers. Oh, a clothesline by Rivers. What's Rivers thinking? Oh, that jumping complete shot he called. Rivers south, and it's a rope break. Too close to the damn ropes. And now he's going for it. Oh, what's he doing here? Oh, no chill. He hits him with the no chill needed. One, two, oh. Oh my God, Devlin not learning the lesson. It looks to me like Scotty Rivers has just snapped. Jordan Devlin. What's this? Oh! Dropped. Oh, we're going to try and get a steal here. Steal! Steal! One! Two! No! Neckbreaker by Scotty Rivers. The no chill needed almost puts this match in the bag for Sinful Youth. Now he goes right off that scoop slam. One, two, three. Sinful, you continue on with the momentum. Your winners of the match, No Chill Scotty Rivers, the Madhouse Marauder, Mark Doering, they are Sinful Youth. Just a reminder, folks, trans rights are human rights. We go from tag team action to championship action. This one's going to be a fun one. Roderick Strong takes on Mick Adams for the Excalibur Championship. This is Mick's 8th championship defense. He wins this one. He's got 2 more, then the cash-in feature is activated. So let's not waste any time. The X-Cal title on the line. A very historic championship here in SIW. I'm also getting word that M Shadows will be back in SIW action in the near future. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall, and it is for the SIW Excalibur Championship. Introducing first, your challenger, Roderick Strong. Roderick Strong stepping out into the H2O Wrestling Center for the first time. This is going to be an absolute banger. That tag team match was very interesting. I don't know how Mark actually ended up recovering from that. And his opponent, your current reigning and defending SIW X-Cal champion, Mick Adams. Here we go, defense number 8 for Mick Adams. This man's been on a roll. And what a roll he has been on. Defeated everybody in his path so far, including Rob Van Dam. But this is Mick's first time here at the H2O Wrestling Center. Roderick Strong, Mick Adams, the Excalibur Championship. Here we go. No, Roderick Strong gonna try and start off strong. No pun intended. Already going up top. Oh, he's watching for him. Oh, but what the hell was that? That was not part of the plan right there. That was interesting. Face buster by Mick Adams after some sort of intergalactic collision. I'm just testing it out with that scoop slam to see if there's any more friggin' intergalactic bullshit that goes on. As Mick Adams goes up top. Now he's gonna fly to the top here and see exactly what happens. If it's done right, it's done right with that double axe handle to the outside here at the H2O Wrestling Center for a debut show here for SIW in this general area. We've already seen some wild action as Mick Adams is going in with the strikes, the chops, and the kicks to the back. That snapmare was absolutely intense. We got a nice little, look at this, into the corner. Hip attack, and it's not done yet. That nice running drop kick. Looks to me like Mick Adams is in control of everything here early on. This could be defense number 8 successful. Beautiful moonsault capitalized. 1, 2, no. And it seems to me like Roderick Strong is in control. Inzaghi, nice. Oh, Reversal City here. Oh, what's this? Oh, Reversal City back and forth. Look at that. Leg sweep, moonsault combination cover. Mick Adams, 1, 2, no. Roderick Strong kicks out. Man, I didn't think this match was going to go this hard as we got serious striking. And some serious back and forth here. Mick Adams with a beautiful reversal. He's going to drop a hold. He's going to try and go. Oh, look at this. Crucifix covered. No, rolling around. Going to try and disorient the guy. Now he finally settles in a position. 2, no. Really trying to expend the energy of Roderick Strong in this matchup. Oh, missing that running kick. Oh, beautiful observation. He's gonna go for it again. Oh, he connects with it. Add to adjustment cover. 1, 2, 3. Just like that, he moves on to defense number 9. That was a fast-paced match. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match and still SIW Excalibur champion, Mick Adams. Well, that was quick, that was fast, and that was just absolutely insane. I did not expect it to go that hard. Well, folks, from a fast-paced championship match to a tag team match, the East-West Express versus Breezango. Jersey Championship Wrestling champion Jordan Oliver teams with his friend Nick Wayne to take on Tyler Breeze and Fandango, or Dirty Dongo, whatever you want to call him. What a quick and easy win for Mick Adams as that was. That was literally like a bounce and a half. So, let's see how intense this one is going to be. As the East-West Express, who at the Collective will be taking on the Motor City Machine Guns for the GCW Tag Team Championships. Which you can find us on Big O Live, calling the action. That's right, the East-West Express will be taking on the Motor City Machine Guns for the GCW Tag Team Championships at the GCW Collective. If you want to know where you can find that information, go to Fight TV. Fight plus $7.99 a month. And you get a chance to watch the entirety of the GCW Collective, as well as the back catalog, including GCW's debut in Toronto, Ontario. And the historic changing of the guard as Masha Slamovich defeated Nick Gage in New York City for the GCW Championship. Now, we're going to bounce into this next match. It's the East-West Express taking on Breezango. Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, he is the Hall of Fame prodigy, Nick Wayne, and his tag team partner, the East Coast Ace, Big Breakfast, and the Jersey Championship Wrestling champion, Jordan Oliver. Together they are the East West Express. And what a tag team these two are. And their opponents. Introducing first, how you doing, Tyler Breeze and Fandango. Together they are Breezango. Breezango making their H2O Wrestling Center debut for SIW. The Fashion Police. Day one is H, whatever you wanna say. This is gonna be an interesting confrontation between these two teams. I believe it. I want it. I want it to happen. Well, welcome to SIW, my friend. I hope he does become champion. I really do. Also, folks, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button as hard as you possibly can. Like that like button so it likes you back. And don't forget to check out GCWmerch.com for all your GCW apparel, event use turnbuckle pads, and more. Speaking of Game Changer Wrestling, here's some game-changing action right here. As Nick Wayne is just taking a beating. That will be very interesting. Thank you very much. I'm from Canada. I hope it's nice up there in South Africa. I hope the weather's doing you a hell of a lot better than it is doing us here in Ontario. It's an absolute confusion dome here as, well, you can see the East-West Express. Nick Wayne's gonna come in now and start some altercation. Jordan Oliver now getting up. And a kick to the face. Back and forth here now. The East-West Express taking it to Tyler Breeze. A series of... Jordan Oliver moves out of the way of Nick Wayne. Now Nick Wayne's got to be very careful. Nick Wayne just eliminated himself. And we got ourselves a... What? No. Hold on. Give me a second, brother. I'm getting word from the back that this match needs to be restarted immediately. This match is being restarted. I think Hogan's back is finished. And so is mine, actually, I'm not gonna lie. As we get our match back together here, Nick Wayne kind of got inside his own head for a moment. And now Nick Wayne is in trouble. As we got ourselves a series of severe... Oh! Ow, what a DDT. Thank God. Nick Wayne now. 17-year-old prodigy. The son of WWE legend Buddy Wayne. And I believe Isla Breeze may just have been busted open. I'm always down to be friends with everybody. Also, folks, if you want more behind-the-scenes action, I do have a Patreon page. Critically Extreme Productions. $5 a month for all the backstage access. That means you get posters, match cards, storyline updates, podcast updates, set lists, and much, much more pertaining to Big O Live and all your Reggins Brand Entertainment needs. And if you are into a much more spicy variant of things, I do have an 18 plus only tier called the VIP room, which is only $10 a month, but it's not gonna be for the faint of heart because there's a lot of things going up on that page. And Batista's filming a movie, I think. As Nick Wayne is just getting tarred and feather right now. Rey Mysterio is indeed gonna be in the Hall of Fame as Nick Wayne delivers a nice kick. Speaking of Hall of Fame, folks, the SIW Hall of Fame is continuing on. We're going to announce our third inductee right after Rite of Spring on the 29th. We want to congratulate both Marcus Crane and Chester Bennington for being a part of the Hall of Fame, as we would like to congratulate that kick for sending Kyler Breeze to the mat. And out comes in the Jersey Championship Wrestling World Champion, and in comes Fandango. I need to get WWE 2K23 eventually. That's Jordan Oliver with a nice kick. Playing some serious games here. Snapmare working the jaw. I do have my social media open right now, just in case if there's anything I have to bring up as, well, Fandango, Dirty Dango coming in with a nice backdrop and a neck breaker. But Jordan Oliver's back up in a clothesline. Jordan Oliver really playing into it. Another clothesline, but this time to the outside. What's the East Coast Ace doing? What is Big Breakfast thinking? The clout cutter. Oh no, taking too much time. As Tyler Breeze gets in his way. And it looks like Fandango, the Dirty Dango, playing some mind games here. Nice arm drag there by Jordan Oliver. That would be very interesting. 2K24, when that comes out, I can't wait to see what happens with that, because 2K23 was pretty damn awesome. Oh, we got some great back and forth here. Nice kick to the face by Jordan Oliver.
with the stripes coming in. Oh, reversal freeze has been busted open with one of Nick Wayne's kicks. That was a nice snap suplex from Jordan Oliver. And no, I am not MLJ, ladies and gentlemen. Even though my voice kind of sounds like him right now, probably because I'm still on vocal rest from St. Patrick's Day. I'm still recovering. As Jordan Oliver delivers a nice drop kick to Fandango. Dirty Dongo with a nice, well, nice little nap on the mat that was just broken up. Irish whip to the outside. Jordan Oliver going to play. Oh, what's this? Jordan Oliver going to the outside. Cross body to the outside. Big breakfast now, trying to get Fandango back into the ring. Nothing wants to work. He's resisting. The more that you push, the more that he resists. And clothesline for his efforts. Nick Wayne gets tagged in. As Nick Wayne is just stalking Fandango. What's this? Oh, gonna try and roll him up here. Oh, is he in the ropes? One count only. We've got ourselves quite the intensity. What's this? Nick Wayne. Oh, what the hell, Nick Wayne? Clothesline into the corner. Oh, we had ourselves a little bit of a collision there. Look at Breeze. Look at the blood pouring down. Oh, backstabber. The blood just pouring down the face of Tyler Breeze. But Tyler Breeze. And what's this? We got a nice back and forth happening. The chops, the strikes. Oh! Nick Wayne. Going, bottom rope moonsault. Beautiful maneuver by Nick Wayne. The Prodigy going, nice little code red there. Cover, one, two, no. My God. Wayne going up top, what's he thinking? Oh, he got sent down, but he's back up. Oh, what's this? Nick Wayne going up top here. Gonna try and go. Oh! Loop the loop cover. One, two. Oh, couldn't even get it off the Rana. He's going up to the middle rope here. Nick Wayne really trying to play games. Clout cutter! Clout cutter of his own. Rope break. And look at this, he's going to try and get Tyler Breeze to get the hell out of the ring. Oh, snapping him around there. Eyes in the back of his head. One, no. Oh, moonsault there by Nick Wayne, who's going to go up. What's he thinking? Oh, double 450 splash cover. One, two, three. And there you have the East-West Express with a phenomenal victory. Your winners of the match, Jordan Oliver, Nick Wayne, the East-West Express. Wow, that was a great tag team match. I thoroughly enjoyed that one. Speaking of Nick Wayne, he will be at DDT Pro Wrestling. That's going to be exciting. We got women's action, fatal four-way. Here we go. Billy Starks, Aaron Chaos, Abby Vex, and Deonna Purrazzo. Deonna Purrazzo, who won the 2023 Women's Calamity Clash match. Aaron Chaos, who felt like they were wronged. Abby Vex, who is the veteran. And Billy Starks, who is also a prodigy of this industry at just 18 years old. But at 17 years old, she main evented Japan. Which is absolutely insane to think about. And you've probably seen her recently on Ring of Honor Television, AEW Dark, and much, much more. So, that is absolutely exciting. So, let's not waste any time. To quote Larry Legend, I don't want to wait any longer. The following Fatal 4-Way contest is scheduled for one fall and features the ladies of SIW Action. Introducing first, she is the 2023 winner of the Calamity Clash match for the women's division. I give you the virtuosa, Deonna Purrazzo. What a woman she is. She came in as a special entrant, a mystery entrant, and won the whole thing. There is Deonna Purrazzo. And her opponents first. Ladies and gentlemen, from Beach Park, Illinois, Abby Vex. Abby Vex has been on a tear since her return. She went MIA for quite some time. Undisclosed issues. Now she's back in action. Introducing next, I give you Space Jesus, Billy Starks. And look at this, Billy Starks is here in the H2O Wrestling Center. We've seen her here before for Hardcore Hustle. So it's exciting to see her back in the H2O Wrestling Center. And ladies and gentlemen, this ain't SIW related. But lately, I've been putting over a lot of independent wrestling. So I'm going to take this moment to put over the lovely Katie Bentz
and her work as Steph on Life is Strange. There is an audiobook that is available now, so go check it out. Probably going to be worth it because it is Katie Bentz. And his Life is Strange. So, good shout out to them. And good shout out to Katie. As Billy Starks enters the ring. And the final participant, Aaron Chaos. Aaron made their return at the Calamity Cup, well, Calamity Clash event. Was within the final four, I believe, and eliminated by Deonna Purrazzo, which started this entire rivalry. But also, Deonna has had her hands full with Vanessa Craven, who is the SIW Women's Champion. Chaos now is trying to manifest their future. Here we go. As my friend would say. As Deonna's gonna get powerbombed. Oh, what a face buster by Billy Stark. As Purrazzo is being absolutely schooled here. Vex and Chaos are going at it. Old rivals. Not even close to a one count there. Now Purrazzo going straight. Oh. Wait, Starks. Wow, the power. Chaos took Vex to the outside. Now Purrazzo rolls out. It's between Billy Starks and Aaron Chaos. What a clash this is right here. Rope break. As Deonna Purrazzo and Abby Vex are slowly coming to their senses. Vex is back in the ring. Purrazzo is back as well. Purrazzo going right for Vex. It's German suplex cover. No, this is Calamity. I think Klaus is gonna go straight for Vex as Vex is distracted, which is not normal. Normally she's got her head on a swivel. Klaus is going right for her rival Aaron Chaos. Chaos takes a nice boot to the chest as now Aaron's on the outside regrouping. Purrazzo takes the turnbuckle to the face. Back up as we got Billy Stark. Oh, Abby Vex with a kitchen sink. One. No. Both women on the outside don't know what's going on inside till now. As Purrazzo is coming back forth with a nice flow over DDT. Vex now in trouble as Purrazzo going right for Billy Starks, taking Starks down. What's this?
Oh! European uppercut right to the back of the head.
Well, everyone's just taking down everyone here. Starks. Chaos. What's this? Oh, bridging that flex. Oh. Zach's in trouble. Oh, neutralizer. Gonna try and steal it here while everyone else is distracted. One, two, no. Peraza almost takes it. Oh wait, Vex with the reversal for Vought Suplex as Starks and Chaos are duking it out on the outside. Oh, we got two matches left, ladies and gentlemen. We got an MMA rules match coming your way and an Iron Man match to close us off. We get a float over DDT by Deonna Purrazzo. Purrazzo now signaling the end as Billy Starks and Aaron Chaos are on the outside.
What's this? What's happening here?
Oh my. Oh, Abby Vex with her veteran instincts. Starks. Oh man. Chaos doesn't know what the hell she's doing. But that's typical. I'm kidding. Vex now into the corner. Peraza with a clothesline. Neckbreaker combination. One, two, three. Deonna Peraza takes it. Your winner of the match, Deonna Peraza. And there you have it, Deonna Peraza. Virtuosa with momentum heading into the Go Home show this Monday before Rite of Spring. Well, folks, our co-main event it's MMA rules, Brock Lesnar versus the Monster Abyss. Are you guys ready? The rules are simple. You can only win by submission or knockout. And you're locked inside a steel cage. MJF chose Brock Lesnar, which could be the Monster Abyss's toughest challenge leading into Survival Fest next month. But Abyss is trying to prove the endurance of MJF tonight in our main event as MJF takes on Kyle O'Reilly in an Iron Man match. But we got ourselves an MMA rules match coming your way. The following contest is our co-main event, and it is an MMA rules match. The way to win is simple. It's either by knockout or submission. No exiting the ring, as you guys will be confined by a steel cage. Introducing first, the Monster Abyss. Abyss won the 2023 Men's Calamity Clash match this past January. And now the monster has a lot on his plate. Can he devour it all in one setting and be the most dominant SIW champion we have? And his opponent, Brock Lesnar! It's been a while since we've seen Brock Lesnar in an SIW CXW ring. The beast has been unleashed. Lesnar is here. And my God, former UFC heavyweight champion knows a thing or two about MMA, if you catch my drift. As he is sizing up the monster. Man. Just circling the ring is Brock Lesnar. Just really zeroing in on his, well, I guess you could say meal. He finally enters the ring. There you see the cage. Co-main event. Also, folks, I am just getting word that it is cold as fuck out there. And the bell sounds. Here we go. MMA rules. And Lesnar's gonna start off. First ever MMA rules match here in the H2O Wrestling Center. And Brock Lesnar is taking it straight to the monster. Abyss really being beat down by Brock Lesnar here. Just thrown into the corner. Oh, finally getting some separation. What's this? He tried to go for a chokeslam early here. Wait, Abyss now coming in with the strikes. What's he thinking? Oh, trying to tease Lesnar a little bit. Throwing him into the cage. And that may have just taken out Abyss in the process. Oh. Jesus Christ, ladies and gentlemen. This match may not even be for the faint of heart, as Abyss is striking everything he's got. Looks to me like Lesnar now is about to get launched into the cage. Remember, it's either by submission or knockout, I believe. Oh, wait, Lesnar. Lesnar on the comeback here. Abyss had his momentum. And now we got ourselves, oh, the Suplex City, bitch. Oh. Oh, Abyss, wait, Abyss is back up. And he ran right into it. He ran right into the F5. Oh my God. Wait, there's a pin? Oh no, he's going right for the arm bar. There's a submission attempt here. Oh wait, Abyss. Abyss just got out of it. Oh, and he drops down. Brock Lesnar. Lesnar with the juke and the jive. But wait. Here comes the monster. And here comes Lesnar. Into the corner. The elbows into the chest area, the chest cavity of the monster Abyss. Abyss now. Ooh. Right in the cranberries. Oh, Lesnar. What's Lesnar thinking? Dropping him down. Abyss is in trouble. Abyss is being absolutely mauled. Wait, the monster trying to make his way back. Lesnar is just completely mauling the guy. Backdrop by the monster Abyss, and it kicked right to the face. What's this? Just using the cage as a weapon. Lesnar now. Oh! Seems like Lesnar's been busted wide open. Abyss. Oh, he's trying to go for it. Black hole slam! Black hole slam! Black hole slam! Oh, wait, Lesnar. Oh, Lesnar gets choke slammed. And a big boot for his troubles. Big boot for the trouble. Oh! Lesnar! Reverse shock treatment! Oh. Abyss with a nerve hold. Really dragging it in. Just gonna really. No! Lesnar. Oh, and a boot. Really working the nerve hold here. Oh, we got a shock treatment! Shock treatment! Oh my god, Abyss won! Abyss just beat Lesnar! Your winner of the match by knockout, the monster, Abyss. Wow. Abyss defeats Brock Lesnar in MMA rules. But before we get on to our main event, here's an update for the Independent Wrestling Hall of Fame. You have current inductees Christopher Daniels, cheerleader Melissa, and Jimmy Jacobs. Joining those three individuals will be Mike Modest, folks. All great things come to an end. It's time for our main event of the evening. Ladies and gentlemen, Iron Man rules. MJF versus Kyle O'Reilly. But like I said, that last match had to be Abyss's toughest challenge. but it was two shock treatments to put down the beast. MJF will not be happy. Is probably not happy. Well, folks, he has time, a lot of it, to repeatedly let his anger out in our main event. So let's not waste any time. To quote Larry Legend, I don't want to wait any longer. The following contest is our main event of the evening, and it is an Iron Man match. Introducing first, he is your SIW champion, Maxwell Jacob Friedman, MJF. MJF coming down to the ring, your SIW champion. And no, this is not for the SIW championship. Indeed, it is not. MJF will be having a tough task ahead of him. This is going to be absolutely insane to see. The salt of the earth versus one of the toughest and most grizzled men in the technical wrestling scene. And his opponent, Kyle O'Reilly. And there he is, ladies and gentlemen. It's Kyle O'Reilly. This main event is an Iron Man match, and it's going to be absolutely intense. If you thought that MMA rules match was violent, well, you're going to be seeing a different type of violence here. Hey, it's Tony Pizza Guy. But here we go. Iron Man rules, the bell sounds, and the main event is underway here in the Hardcore Hustle Wrestling Center, the H2O Wrestling Center, the Kevin Hogan Memorial Hall, as MJF and Kyle O'Reilly gonna open up a can of whoop-ass upon each other. Great back and forth, starting things off here as Kyle O'Reilly takes MJF into the corner. Iron Man rules. Nice boot scrape right there. Nice beluga kick kind of maneuver as MJF is up. And he's not rattled. Oh, he will be after that. Oh, MJF. The strikes. Coming into play. Clothesline into the corner. Dropping the knee once, scraping the boot the second time. Nice reversal and a takedown by MJF, proving why he is our world champion. Series of great strikes. And now that series of strikes has been reversed for a series of strikes of his own. That wasn't enough. MJF still ahead of the curve. As he's about to... Oh, shoulder breaker. Elbow right to the top of the dome. MJF saying some words, not pissed off Kyle O'Reilly.
that ground and pound style. Going for that armbar, but that armbar was not enough. MJF with a reversal. Oh, what's this? Oh. Oh, kick right to the nads. MJF kicks him right in the nads. Brings him up. Crossroads. Crossroads, now we got a cover. Oh, rope break. MJF gonna set him up for something here. Already. And try and get that first fall. What's he setting up for? For some reason, it ain't going the way it wants for MJF. Salt of the earth. Salt of the earth. Could this be it? The salt of the earth. Oh, he reached the rope. Kyle O'Reilly reaches the ropes. Hooks or dragon screw. Oh, MJF gonna try and steal it now. Is that what he's thinking? Referee gets in position. One, two, three. MJF has scored his first fall. He's gonna try it again here. Look at this. One, no. Scraping the face with the boot and a kick right to the back of Kyle O'Reilly. MJF with the first fall. Wait, Kyle O'Reilly, exploder suplex. Oh, he's kicking him in. He's caving in the chest of MJF. Wait, MJF gets up. Oh. Powerbomb! Powerbomb City, we got a cover here. One, two, no. MJF, neckbreaker. Did that neckbreaker be enough? One, two, no. MJF has him sized up. What's he going for here? Salt of the earth. But Kyle O'Reilly once again stuck his foot on the rope. He reached the rope twice for that. What's this, MJF? Setting him up here. We are outside in the H2O Wrestling Center. MJF is just working on damaging the head of Kyle O'Reilly. O'Reilly now trying to make a quick comeback. Oh, drops him on his head. MJF is down. Drops him on his head. All the strikes to MJF's pretty face. One, no. And yes, I am being told to say that, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. MJF is back up, and he is coming in with a set of strikes of his own. Boot scrape. That dreaded little boot scrape. Dropping the elbow right to the back. Oh, wait. Kyle O'Reilly with a leg sweep. And we got a strike coming back in. Oh, reversal by Kyle O'Reilly. Double underhook series. Oh, that double underhook. Double underhook slam jam. No. MJF is down. What's Kyle O'Reilly thinking here? Oh, what's this? Oh, he's got him. He's got him down. Oh, he's gonna tap. He's gonna tap. MJF is gonna tap.
Look at this. Oh! Oh! Kyle O'Reilly has his fall. And MJF with a reversal of his own. Crossroads. Oh, he's backing him up. He's backing it up. What's he thinking? Oh, he's bringing him down. Salt of the earth again into the ropes. What's he thinking? What's MJF really thinking? Boot slam. Oh, right in the middle of the ring, too. Right in the middle of the ring. Salt of the earth. Salt of the earth. Oh my god, MJF gets another fall. We go MJF and Kyle O'Reilly back and forth. Wait, MJF gonna try and steal it here. One, two, three. MJF steals another fall. MJF has gained two falls to one here. As Kyle O'Reilly with that beautiful exploder. And a brain buster. We're going for the cover. One, two, three. No. No, 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 no. Oh, what's this? And go for a guillotine choke again. MJF. MJF is fighting. And fighting hard. Oh, he got out of it. MJF got out of it. Drops him down. Oh, look at that. MJF, small package. Small package. One, two, three. MJF steals another fall. The Chop City here, back and forth. And let's go. Those double underhooks. My god. Kyle O'Reilly in control of this match at this moment. One, two, three. He gains a fall. It's 4-2 MJF right now with 5 minutes remaining in this Iron Man match main event. MJF with a nice strike, close fist, and he's raking the boot across the face of Kyle O'Reilly. What's he thinking? What is MJF thinking? Into the corner he goes. And that forearm shot. And a boot scrape. MJF really trying to bring the heat here as time is running down. The salt of the earth in this 15-minute Iron Man match. Bringing forth a combination. 4-2 right now, MJF. Salt of the earth, Kyle O'Reilly reaches the ropes. I think those ropes are what's saving him from being in a deeper deficit. Clothesline into the corner. And another boot scrape by MJF. And what's he thinking here? Small package once more. He opens the door. One, two, three. He gains another fall. All these small packages. Just coming into play as he goes for a shoulder breaker. A kick to the back. Kyle O'Reilly is in trouble. O'Reilly now with the sweep. Clothesline combination. Cover. One, two, three.
MJF is just picking up win after win. No! Crossroads! Gonna go for it here. He's just really trying to bridge that gap. There's seven. Salt of the earth. Fall number eight. MJF is just bringing it in. There's 2 minutes and 26 seconds. And he's dropping him on his shoulder once more. And tosses him to the outside. MJF now on the floor here of the Hardcore Hustle Organization's H2O Wrestling Center. Shoulder breaker on the outside here. Oh, but Kyle O'Reilly coming back real quick. Neck breaker on the outside. Into the barricade he goes. We've got ourselves a case of one-upsmanship out here. Kyle O'Reilly dropping him on his neck. Oh, MJF gets thrown into that barricade in the ring at five here. Referee's gonna have to count. But he breaks the count. Oh, MJF fighting back. What's he thinking here, MJF? Oh, wait. Kyle O'Reilly. The push, the pull, and the forth and back. German suplex to the O. Just exploding out of that generic spot. Oh, back and forth we go. Six. A stunned MJF. Seven. Breaks the count. Very stunned. Another German suplex to the outside. Reversal and a neck breaker. And time runs out. MJF wins. Your winner of the Iron Man match, Maxwell Jacob Friedman, MJF. Wow, time ran out. MJF dominating in an instant classic like he always does. You gotta wonder, how much more can these two men put each other through before Survival Fest? Well, folks, we have it all here. Next week is the Go Home Show. We will be at the Opera House in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. And here is the card for next week. We have Emma McGann taking on Alley Catch. Mick Adams goes for his ninth defense as he takes on Matt Cardona for the X-Cal Championship. We got the debut of Peyton Sawyer as she takes on Anna Valentine. Then we got two teams with hella momentum going at each other. Sinful Youth, that's No Chill Scotty Rivers, and the Madhouse Marauder himself, Mark Daring, taking on Jordan Oliver and Nick Wayne of the East West Express. Then we have the Hardcore Championship, which will be on the line as M Shadows takes on Hoodfoot.
Our co-main event will be Abyss versus Umaga, and then our main event will be for the SIW Championship, as requested by Abyss. MJF will have to defend against Austin Theory. And here are the matches confirmed for SIW Rite of Spring. We will have the Tag Team Championships on the line. Los Macizos will defend against whoever wins next week. We have Pete Dunne taking on Mick Adams if Mick Adams retains the X-Cal title. If the Hardcore title does not change hands, we could have a potential M Shadows versus Matt Tremont match. Then our 2-on-1 handicap match. It's going to be Aaron Chaos versus Deonna Purrazzo and Vanessa Craven. Then our main event, it's going to be MJF teaming up with Cruel to take on Abyss and Kevin Nash in tag team warfare. So we got plenty of matches still to confirm. But ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys so much for hanging out here for SIW Agony. We will see you Monday night for a very special go-home show.